first half of the Georgia Southern game. We just we came out slow. My last two halftime speeches, I think I got tape in the starter at the beginning of the game because we were a different team in the second half. I thought George Sessions was amazing. I thought it was his energy. I thought he won it for us on the defensive end. DeMarcus kind of did his thing on the offensive end. But I thought George Sessions was absolutely terrific tonight. I think he had 10 rebounds in the second half alone. The whole talk was we were down 24-10 on the glass in the first half. Mm-hmm. And I was livid, absolutely livid. Especially after giving up 21 offensive rebounds the day before. Our defense is so good, but we got to play defense sometimes two or three different times on one possession. But again, these kids fight. They fought hard. I thought Malik made a couple of big baskets when we really. I thought DeMarcus got tired and Malik made a couple of big baskets. Again, great environment. I thought our crowd was really into it and really helped. So questions.
What was the message at halftime?
My mom kind of watches this, and so if I told you maybe some of the stuff I said, she wouldn't be happy. It was just about, I didn't think we played the right way. One thing I love about coaching this team is that we played the right way. When we get in a situation where we come down and we make one passing shot, we're not very good, and we lose games. When we come down and we get the ball side to side, there's not a team in this league we feel like we can't beat. So, you know, sometimes the games, they think it comes easy for them. They think they're open, but that's not necessarily what we need to do. So we had to emphasize that and then rebound it. And to say the least, I just wasn't happy. Because, again, I thought that they played harder than we did.
Coach, you shot 50% second half versus 34 in the first. What do you think attributed to that?
We took away the ball screen. We thought that they really kept us on one side of the floor on the ball screen. So we took it out and got the ball. We reversed it straight to Malik. Catch the ball on the other side, and got it side to side, and we were able to get the ball switched from there. And it let more spacing for DeMarcus to drive. And then he was finding shooters. He really just had some great passes finding shooters. So we took the ball screen away, and I thought that really would help. I thought that was a great adjustment by the head coach of Georgia State. I thought he did a great job. I got to get two more on my assistant and take the credit for that.
Coach, UTA, they have great length. Mm-hmm. But you guys had 46 points in the paint compared to their 26 points. What do you think was the key there?
They have great length, but what I love about our kids, we have great heart. A lot of times that great heart will win out most of the time. Our kids got heart. We didn't make any substitutions. I haven't played like seven guys. They played with heart and determination that they want to win. So that's what makes this group special.
You took a timeout with 11 minutes and 50 seconds in the second half, and at that point you were down. After that timeout, you took the lead. What did you tell the team during that timeout?
Just getting stops and get back to what we were doing offensively. Again, we get in trouble when we just make one passing shot. And so, again, I got to keep reminding them that. And we kind of made a couple of adjustments defensively because I thought they were getting too easy of shots. So we made a little adjustment. And then I think we got four or five straight stops after that. Kind of got us going.
Okay, so the Panthers obviously defended the Sports Arena tonight. Now, with regards to last season, would you say that tonight was more of a redemption?
I don't believe in redemption and all that because there were different players and that were on different teams. You know, each year you get a different team. We're in a fight for a championship. We don't have time for redemption and those things. When you're trying to fight for a championship and we got that team ahead of us that hadn't lost yet, so we got to keep winning. And so it doesn't matter who we're playing right now. We have to win every home game. That's why I've been begging, and I'll continue to beg our students, continue to come out. We need you. I thought the crowd kind of got DeMarcus going, which got our team going. That, you're supposed to be about a 10-point favorite at home because of your crowd. Our crowd did it again. We need our students. Again, come out Saturday. Come out. I'm giving out free popcorn, free pizza. If I could, I'd give you free shoes. Please continue to come out. Pack this place out for Saturday. Again, we need you. I'm just kidding about the shoes. Somebody's already called me. I told some students I would give them free popcorn, and they went up to the concession stand, and I got a bill the other day.
Coach, you talked about it a little bit already, but this has been a kind of a few game stretch now for Jordan. Talk about just kind of he's just in the zone right now.
He's playing well, and I said again, you don't win championships unless your seniors play well. And this man, he's playing. I mean, Jordan's been around as long as I've got. I've been around. We do our taxes and stuff together. He's so old. He's just a guy that's been around. He understands. He's the only guy left from that NCAA tournament team. He wants to go back before it's over. This is it for him. And he is playing like a desperate guy right now. I love his energy. I love his passion right now. He is playing great basketball, and I'm really happy for him. Because that's when you're a senior, that's how he's supposed to go out. And he's going out with a bang right now.
So just another game, another opponent under 40% shooting, and 10-4-17 turnovers tonight. Can you speak a little bit about the consistency on defense as of lately?
Well, if we're going to win this thing and we're going to win the championship, it's going to be because of our defense. We're one of the best teams, not only in the league, but in the country right now. I think we're in the top 20 in so many defensive categories. We're the best defensive team in the league in regards to field goal percentage defense. You know, we get steals, we get block shots, we get tons of deflection, and we love playing defense. You know, some guys talk about it, but that's something we love to do. Our goal is always to keep people under 40%. Again, a lot of teams can try to keep people under 50. That'd be unheard of for us. And so we have to continue to let our defense do the talking for us, because again, our offense is going to be good enough, it's going to come around, but defensively is where we're going to win a championship.
Coach, speaking of defense, your team had one steal in the first half, but in the second half it had six total steals. What changed to result in that many forced turnovers in the second half?
Playing harder and smarter. I think that was the most important thing. We didn't play real smart early, but we played harder in the second half. And when you play hard, good things are going to happen. You know, good, when you're a good defensive team, you want to get the flexes. And so we were able to jump the passing lanes. And I think the play that Marcus made with the guy that didn't even see him underneath the bound, and he throws it in, DeMarcus gets the flexion and steal. Again, just a heads up. That's a basketball IQ play. And so, and that's what I mean by being a smart team.
Coach, you talked about a few weeks ago about the guards getting to the free throw line more, getting the right guys to the line. Jeff got the line five times tonight, made all five. He seemed to do a good job of attacking the basket, getting in the lane tonight too.
Yeah, I was on Jeff early in the game. I thought Jeff was, you know, when Jeff plays well, we rarely lose. And so he just mentally, I didn't think he was there. And I thought the spark he put in the second half was really good. And we need to get him to the line. He's a great free throw shooter. So again, we're trying to get the right guys to the free throw line. And again, I think this is the fourth or fifth straight game that we shot over 70% because the right guys are shooting free throws, especially at the end of the games.
I noticed some frustration you had with the refs. Can you talk to us about that?
I love the refs. I think they tried to make me lose some money in my paycheck. I love the refs. I thought they did a wonderful job. I love the color scheme that they wore today. The way they blew the whistle was fantastic. I love the sound that it made. That's all I have to say.
And on that note,